Hi, my name's Danny Lacey. I'm the CEO and founder of Starter Media. We're a content marketing agency based in Wakefield, south of Leeds, in the north of England. And what you're about to watch is series one of The Diary of an Entrepreneur. For anybody who's running a business, set up a business, you'll know that it's almost mission impossible to get a business off the ground. The statistics of businesses failing in the first few years is astonishing. There's also the psychological aspect of running a business that people very rarely talk about. So I decided a couple of years ago that I was going to document the journey as we grow this incredibly ambitious agency, with the end goal being one of the top agencies in the UK. And we may be a few years away from that at the minute, but what you're going to watch is that journey as we head in that direction. So this was filmed over the last couple of years. The business has evolved and changed since then, but at least it gives you some context of the fight that we've actually been through to get to this moment in time where we've survived all the ups and downs and we're still growing now more than we've ever done before. So I hope you find this series motivational, inspirational. You may be going through similar situations yourself within your business. Please do get in touch. Give me your feedback, share and like. And above all else, I hope you enjoy watching The Diary of an Entrepreneur, and I hope that you get to take something away from it for your business. So here we are in our old office, and we're in the process of moving office at the minute, and there's still so much of work going on. So it's juggling a lot of things. It's getting ready for the office move, which is logistically quite fraught because there's IT to think about, furnishings, etc., while still trying to run a business. So this is the old office. So we've got what used to be our conference room. We've got Lauren in the corner, who's our account exec. Then we've got Ben, who is our creative, kind of lead creative. He also project managers, he can film, he can edit, he's kind of very multi-talented. She's not at her desk! So this looks like a bit of a bomb site at the minute. And then in here, this is where our post-production team hang out. Moving this is quite tough because we've got all the servers and getting the timing right is important. So yeah, this is quite a big moment for us. So we're going from this office, which we've been in for about 3 years now. So we've had a few issues with it recently. And we've kind of outgrown it a little bit, but because it's so dated and kind of old school, and we need something a bit more modern, because this is the problem you get to in business, you know. This was cheap and cheerful and did exactly what we wanted it to do. Unfortunately, we need something a little bit more upmarket, so to speak, especially when we bring in high net worth clients through who are spending thousands with the company. We want to come across as a company that's worthy of those thousands being spent on them. We've had a good look around. We found this office in Wakefield that ticks all the boxes. It's a little bit more expensive, but not much. Very, very similar to what we're paying now, but we get a lot more bang for us buck. And the way we've kind of worked this, we've just given us notice into this office, and we get the first month free at this place, and they overlap so that we're not having a cut-off day. We've had the internet installed, which is very important for what we're doing. Kat and the team are coming out later on to talk to some service people to get quotes for some decorating that we want doing and a few of the bits like security needs improving. I want some bars on the windows downstairs, added locks and security on the front doors, etc. So it's little things like that, and luckily, because of the way we've set up the move, we get a bit of time to do that, which would be nice. One of the biggest headaches when it comes to offices is parking, especially when you've got staff. You know, how easy is it for your staff to get where they're going? Obviously, you don't want your staff to have to pay a fortune in parking, which it would be if we did day rate parking. So we've done a deal with a local shopping centre, and we're using their multi-storey car park. And again, we're going to subsidise a bit of it. But it's stuff like that that you just don't often think about. This is us. The Wool Stapler building. So here it is, new office, and it's definitely an improvement from what we've got right now. More modern, there's a bit of work to do to it still. So we need bars over the windows, which is going to help with insurance to keep the premium down. So let's give you a grand tour downstairs. Kirby, just watch your step. So this is going to be where we're going to keep all the kit and the IT. We're also going to have this as like a mini studio as well. We'll be able to film like talking heads and stuff. And we'll also have a sound booth down here as well, so we can record voiceovers, temp voiceovers. Hangout area, foodie, cafeteria, kitchen thing with toasters and fridges and a little seating area for people to hang out. We're going to sort the lighting out because it's a bit dull. This will be our conference room. So we're going to have a TV on the wall, we're going to have our conference table here, a bit of branding, something funky on that wall. I don't know what it is, I think Kat and Lauren are working on that at the minute. Right, so this is the first floor. Also, so this is the production office. It's where all the admin will take place. Got all the IT stuff in. Nice view out the window, really nice cool part of town. Toilet on the landing, again this will be unisex, which is fine. Boiler. But that needs to be checked. This is the post-production room. Big open space, lovely wooden beams, brighter, more open plan, a little less stuffy than what we've got already. Stuff that's often overlooked when you get in an office is IT, electrics, all the utilities. So we don't have the money to buy an office right now, but this is perfect. And actually it ticks that box. We can have it, we can buy it after 12 months. So the other thing you've got to look at as well is, and these again are hidden costs, we had to sign a very detailed lease, but I had to pay a solicitor to come in to read through it and to check, and luckily, thankfully, I did that because they've spotted all sorts with the lease that needed fixing, dropping, changing, tweaking. Make sure you get the tenancy agreement, the lease, the contract, whatever you want to call it, make sure you get that checked by a professional who is a special commercial as well, property solicitor, not just any old solicitor, there needs to be a specialist. Otherwise that could potentially bite you in the ass. One of the clauses that they pulled out of the contract was that he could have charged us anything for repairs when we leave the property in 5 years. He could have literally just, it's an open checkbook, and they spotted that and changed it, and now that's out of the contract. But that could have bitten us in the ass, and that's not something that I want my little business to have to go through anytime soon. So what we'll get out of this building compared to the relatively small cost for us will be tenfold at the end of the day. So I think it was worth it. So Kat has been tasked with designing the whole building basically. Each floor is different, different themes. And now we're going through the budget for each floor. This is where I get nervous.
So what you're gonna have is this wall here will be wallpaper, like a feature wall.
Wallpaper or painting?
Wallpaper. Yeah. You're going to have conference chairs, conference table, TV on the wall.
Mm-hmm. So this is the thing, we've got a little budget and Kat's just trying to do the best she can with what she's got really. So this is more like of a waiting room now, isn't it? Because
like
you're going to be up there.
Yeah, we've decided yeah. Lauren's
which is not, I prefer that.
So the idea for here is you're going to have one solid colour from the edge of the door, so that the minute people walk in it's almost recognisable, bright colour. All the way across to the corner. Eventually we'd like screens on this wall that say Stada logo, big screens, but for the time being it'd just be big Stada logo, final.
Should we go on a tour? The team have worked really hard on kind of finding cheap, like the decorator, he charged us just over 500 quid to paint the whole building. We've got a little bit of damp coming through, but we're gonna fix all that. Those are kind of little things we'll worry about. So on the first floor, we've got our water cooler where people will hang out and talk. But in here, we've got the customer care room, I like to call it. So we've got project management, account management, creative design. And up here is production room. So this is, I guess, this is where the magic happens. So here's where everything is, all the video content is basically created. So that's it, basically, four floors. We've still got a lot to do yet. Over here, we're gonna have this as the viewing area. So there'll be a couch, sofa, whatever you wanna call it, coffee table, and the TV is gonna go on the wall at the back with the soundbar. So when we're ready to view a first edit, or if we wanna bring a client round who wants to sit through the edit and feedback in real time, they can do that in the comfort of a sofa. And that's pretty much it. Photographs on the wall, just so when you walk in, it's just got that agency feel about it. It's still not 100% yet. There's still a few things to do. So we thought it was too good to be true, and we moved in and we know everything was going okay until we discovered that the building had an issue. Lead piping coming into the building, don't want to poison the team. So Yorkshire Water have very kindly sent us out drinking water. until they fixed the lead piping, and thankfully they took responsibility for it, otherwise that could have been thousands of pounds. However, what we are responsible for is, this looks like a crime scene out here at the minute with the tape down, but we've got woodworm, we've got fucking weeble, and those little things are chewing away all the woodwork downstairs in the basement, and we're gonna have to step in and fix it at some point. We thought, originally thought, too good to be true, and pretty much it was. And now we were hit with jobs that needed doing to the value of thousands of pounds.
£2,500, which we don't have at the minute, so we're trying to figure out a plan to get that done, but it'll be fixed soon enough, I reckon. And then the boiler, because it's obviously getting cold now, so we've got the winter months coming in, and the boiler isn't working, never has worked. And we had a quote through from that, so that's £1,500 to have that fixed. We've got £2,500, £1,500 to get the boiler fixed. In the meantime, we're just getting these industrial heaters in and having them switched on when it's cold.
When we make the next office move, we're going to be spending a lot more time and investment in surveying the property we're about to move into. Make sure that the woodwork's fine. That'll be my first thing I do. Make sure the boiler's working and everything else that's in there is physically working and in good shape, and itemizing everything as well and making sure we have a solid copy of what's good and bad about the place. The single biggest thing I've learned through this whole process of moving offices, everything is negotiable, everything. Rent for this building, we negotiated that. We got that first month for free. Negotiating with the utilities companies. Parking, for example, we worked with the local shopping centre and negotiated a really good price on parking for all of the staff that we subsidise part of. Don't go in there with the first price. Always have that conversation. If you can't get them down on price, whoever they are, then talk about a free period. So like the first month, 2 months free. Because when you're moving office, and it's a very expensive process moving office, every penny counts, every pound counts. So it's definitely worth going back, negotiating and bartering and getting the best possible deal you can get.
We're running out of cash. It's taking too long to get my money through, and I have a responsibility as the head of the business to keep the business alive.